Very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start with India's relations with China. As you all know that China is the immediate neighbor of India, and China is quite large country, and the relations between India and China were peaceful and full of confrontation also. China became a communist country in the year 1949, and India was the first nation to recognize communist government in China. The first Panchi, the joint enunciation, the five principles of peaceful coexistence were signed between Indian Prime Minister Nehru and Chinese Prime Minister Premier Zhou Enlai on 29th April 1954. And moreover, after signing this, the Panchsheel Agreement, Hindi Chini Bhai Bhai slogan became very, very popular. There were certain confrontation between India and China. The expectations were realized soon, and both the countries were involved in one of the war, that was 1962. And the reason behind the main issues of dispute and confrontations were the Tibet issue. Tibet is a country that is between China and India. As China started annexing Tibet in 1950, and they also started the attacking the people of Tibet, that's why the people of Tibet, they started getting the asylum in India. And one of the important leaders of Tibet, Dalai Lama, he also entered and asked for political asylum from India. As political asylum was granted to Dalai Lama, but this was not seen as a good view by China, and China was watching it as India is interfering in the internal affairs of China and has been encouraging Dalai Lama against China. China ne ये सोचा कि दलाई लामा को जो शरण इंडिया ने दी है उस शरण के कारण वह उनके इंटरनल मैटर्स में इंटरफेयर कर रहे हैं एंड मोर ओवर दे आर एनकरेजिंग दलाई लामा अगेंस्ट चाइना. द नेक्स्ट दिस वाज तिब्बत इशू. तिब्बत के लोगों का ये इशू था. इसके अलावा बॉर्डर इशू है. इन 1957 एंड 59 चाइना एक्सटेंडेड हर होल्ड इन अक्साई चिन रीजन एंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट important region, that was Arunachal Pradesh. China says that Arunachal Pradesh is a part of China's territory, and it was claiming a large part of its area. And in the meantime, in 1962, in both the disputed regions, the first attack lasted 1 week, and the Chinese forces captured some key areas in Arunachal Pradesh. The second attack hua, wo ek month baad hua. While the Indian forces could block the Chinese advances on the western front in Ladakh, in the east, the Chinese managed to advance nearly to the entry point of Assam Hills. Beshak, Indian soldiers ne unhe rokne ka pura prayas kiya, koshish ki, lekin wo Assam plains tak badhne mein bilkul hi kamyab ho gaye. And this was one of the, because India had faced an unexpected attack from China on both the regions of Aksai Chin and Arunachal Pradesh, then called was NEFA. NEFA stands for Northeastern Frontier Agency. So India has to face a setback, and after that India has to get military help from some of the nations that were the with whom India was having good relations. India's image at home and abroad, that was also very, very bad at that time. At the end of the war, many leaders and many army generals, defense minister V. Krishna Menon, and some top army commanders, they either resigned or retired. Now, today's position, what we see that in this map, if you see, there are the disputed area, the whole of the Arunachal Pradesh we call it Eastern Sector, and it is 1,325 kilometers long area. Some of the parts of Arunachal Pradesh, they are being captured by China. Much part of Arunachal Pradesh is under China. The central region, central sector, comes some parts of Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. It is 545 kilometers long. And the disputed area is Aksai Chin area that comes under western sector, and that was 1570 kilometers long. Now let us see that what happened on the on the main date of 15th of June 2020, there are 3 points. This area, which is ceded by Pakistan to China, it has given as a gift from Pakistan side to China, this grey portion. And this grey portion is Aksai Chin area. Under that, Galwan Valley falls. Line of actual control is this one, and Hot Springs and Pangong Lake. In Tino Sthano par is bar standoff hue hain. The soldiers from Indian side, they have to face the terrible SPAS line of actual control. It has witnessed a terrible SPAS near the Galwan River, and instead of using the ammunition, spiked clubs were used, metal rods were used, and for that reason, it's very sorry to say that 20 Indian soldiers were killed by Chinese soldiers. Literally, there were some of the soldiers, they fell, and they were pushed to their death. And from China's side, no casualties has been reported. So it was the worst crisis between India and China relations from the last 50 years. And China is having the policy of expanding. And due to expansion policy, China is trying to annex the areas of Arunachal Pradesh and Aksai Chin areas. And that is why now India has started banning all the things from China's side. And the latest news is that in the South China Sea, the warships from United States have started coming, and the India and United States, they are trying to create a pressure on China so that the problem can be sorted out. Otherwise, China खुद अपने एक्सपेंशन की नीति को चलाता है, और एक्सपैंड करने के लिए वो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा एरियाज को, अक्साई चिन और अरुणाचल प्रदेश के एरियाज को अपने में अनेक्स करने की कोशिश करता है. नाउ द वर्ल्ड पावर्स, बिकॉज एज यू ऑल नो दैट देयर इज अ कोल्ड वॉर बिटवीन गोइंग ऑन बिटवीन चाइना एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ COVID-19, the main responsibility comes over China only, and China wants to make its own hegemony in the world, and that is why the COVID-19 or corona, it has been started, and it was one of the biological attacks started by China in whole of the world, and that is why the whole world is against China. And United States especially is facing a cold war with China, and it is helping and supporting India against China. This is all with today's point. Thank you. Stay at your houses and stay safe.